I've always felt that there should have been an album before Bleach, because by the time that we recorded the songs off of Bleach, we were really into that kind of music. I mean, we don't regret it now, you know, because that was just a period of our band. That was just part of our progression, you know. We were really into experimental, noisy, like Butthole Surfers kind of music, you know. And there's just, I mean, that's always been the case with us. We always should have put out something a little bit before the last record, you know. Also, that we did feel a little bit of pressure, a little bit of intimidation by the whole Seattle scene, because everyone was so heavily into this retro 70s thing. The shows that we've been playing on this tour, you know, to realize that there are that many people, that many kids our age, that basically have the same views as we do and like the same kind of music, you know, that's a really amazing thing. That's a really positive thing. And things just change all the time, you know. And 1990 was the year for change. It was just something. It was about time, you know, it was the beginning of a new decade.
We were practicing a lot, and we were writing a lot of material. We'd write them, they were great, for like 2 weeks. Oh my God, this is the best song ever. And we'd forget them. And so then we decided, okay, well, we'll start putting them on cassette. So we started recording them onto these boombox things, and we'd lose the cassettes, you know. And so, I mean, we wrote so much material that we just, like, forgot about. And every once in a while, we'll, like, pull one out and turn it around.
Kurt and I were totally into the Vaseline's. I mean, they were my favorite band. They still are one of my favorite bands.
Definitely our number one favorite band.
Happy Halloween. This song was written by a band called the Vaseline's. They're from Edinburgh, Scotland, and they're a very punk rock. Jesus, don't want me for a sunbeam. Sunbeams are not very like me. Don't expect me to cry for all the reasons you have to die. Don't ever ask you love me.
It's usually done on acoustic guitar, sitting around in my underwear, just picking out riffs, pieces of songs.
Maybe Kurt will come in with a melody a guitar riff and show it to us.
We go to practice and then we play the song over and over and over again.
We just jam. There's no real formula.
Chris and Dave have a big part in deciding on how long a song should be and how many parts it should have. So I don't like to be considered as the whole songwriter, but I do come up with the basis of it. I come up with a singing style during practice, and then I write the lyrics usually minutes before we record.
The song is called Smells Like Teen Spirit.
Necessarily working, we're just practicing, just trying to make songs because the studio was available.
Mm-hmm.
And we just like to jam sometimes, so we decided to do a little bit of pre-production for our next record, see what the new songs would sound like recorded, and maybe add some parts and just make some songs, you know. Mm-hmm.